What's going on, guys? It's your boy, the Markham Knight here. Today's video is going to be all about Zack Snyder's Justice League, and this is going to be part 4 of 7 of my breakdown of Zack Snyder's Justice League, and this one is going to focus on the change engine, is what this part's called. So let's get right into it. The first thing we get to see is that Jim Gordon has turned the Bat Signal on, so Batman, Wonder Woman, and Flash have gone to the Bat Signal, and there are some jokes there. Obviously, this is the first time he's seeing Wonder Woman and Flash, but then they also get joined by Cyborg, which makes Wonder Woman really proud. But Cyborg basically tells them that these people are abducting Star Labs people, and that's probably because of their connection to the Mother Box. And then they go basically to under Stryker's Island. It's all underground. It's also under the Gotham Harbor. And they go there to fight Steppenwolf and find all these abducted people and save them at the same time trying to take Steppenwolf down. And this is a really, really cool fight scene. We get a big throwdown between Wonder Woman and Steppenwolf, and Wonder Woman holds her own for the most part, but Steppenwolf looks like he might be a little more powerful than she is, and obviously he's also a great warrior. He's taken down over 100,000 worlds, apparently, and he's trying to take down 50,000 more. So they all have a pretty cool fight scenes. There's some cool stuff that each one of them get to do. And then we get to see kind of a nice little moment between Cyborg and his dad. His dad says, "I didn't think you were coming," and he says, "You're my father." And I like that it's not corny and they're not just suddenly happy and Victor's not just suddenly happy with his dad again. It's just kind of very straight up business, like, yeah, you're my dad, obviously I'm gonna save you. Like, I still care about you. It's not gonna be like, I'm gonna let you die just because what we have going on. So that was pretty cool. And then at the end of the fight, basically Steppenwolf, he takes one of the bombs that Cyborg shoots at him and he lets it go into the wall, and the Gotham Harbor is coming in. Steppenwolf booms out and we get to see Aquaman join the team for the first time, and it's a pretty cool entrance that he has there. And then Vic flies off and the rest of the team are kind of hanging out. And then we basically get to see Steppenwolf goes back, he uses the boom tube, and he goes back to the Mother Boxes, and the Mother Box is calling out to him, and it wants to show him something. So then Steppenwolf takes a look at what the Mother Box wants to show him, and it turns out that this is the same world that fought Darkseid's army off before. And if you remember correctly, Darkseid was Uxus at the time, and he was defeated by them, and he was incapacitated when they left that world, and that world was then lost to them, because they didn't have the connection to the Mother Boxes, because the Mother Boxes went dormant. So Steppenwolf has found that world, and then when he strikes his axe to the floor, he sees the anti-life equation is carved in the floor, just like Darkseid did the first time that he did it, and he wants to speak to Desaad, and he wants Desaad to tell Darkseid, he wants to plead to see Darkseid, because he wants to tell Darkseid he's found this world for him, and he will conquer this world for him. And then we kind of see something really, really cool. It's the first time we get to see Darkseid fully realized in his armor and everything, and he is exposed to us, and he's really cool. His voice and everything's pretty awesome and everything, and he basically says he's been destroying hundreds of thousands of worlds to try and find this anti-life. Now let me explain to you what the anti-life equation is. So the anti-life equation is basically the thing that Darkseid hit on the floor. That thing, if once you have full knowledge of the anti-life equation, then you can control all living beings in the entire multiverse. That means not just this universe, the same universe that would be on the TV shows and stuff like that, you would control people's free will on every single universe. You can decide what they want to do and everything. So essentially they would all become slaves to Darkseid. And that's what Darkseid wants. He wants full free will. He wants to take everyone's free will from them, and he wants all to worship Darkseid. So he tells Steppenwolf, find the third Mother Box, scorch this earth, because once the unity happens, the world will be scorched, kind of like it was in the Darkseid apocalyptic scenes and stuff. And once this world is scorched, he'll come back and he'll take the anti-life equation for himself. And that's how Steppenwolf has to get back into his good graces. And obviously Steppenwolf says, anything for you, master. He kind of bows down and he's exposed himself for the first time. And in the actual trailers, he looked pretty weird, exposed completely like that. But here the CGI is done really, really well, and you can see it, and it looks really, really good. And it looks like he kind of has like a lizard-like or like scorched body type, and that could be because he's been burnt up, or that could be just kind of the skin that he has, because Desaad does have kind of similar skin to that as well. So that's pretty cool. And then we get back to the superheroes, and they're still on the roof, and they're like, well, he has both the mother boxes, all he needs the third one, then he can start the Unity. And then they say, well, maybe he already has the third one, and Cyborg jumps in, and he says, they don't have the third one, I do. And then they all head off to the Batcave, and we get to see Cyborg kind of explain what the mother box is. Now, Cyborg's explanation of the mother box is pretty interesting. Flash asks if it's a murder machine, and he says no, it's more of a change machine. It can change matter into different forms. Like, basically, the example they gave was that if you burn a house down, the house turns to smoke and ash and everything, but it doesn't mean that those particles of the house don't exist. They've now just become particles of smoke and ash. So what the mother box can do is turn that smoke and ash back into a house. And then obviously that means that they can also turn Superman back alive as well, because the particles are all there. The mother box can just give it life and turn it back into the pre-dead form. And that's kind of what they plan to do. Now, Batman kind of has a cool moment where he's talking about Superman and saying, obviously, the mother boxes were scared of him because the Victor's dad, he used the mother box to create Cyborg, so he had to wake it up. And even though it was woken up, it did not call out to Steppenwolf, it did not call out to Darkseid or anything, because it was scared of Superman. So that's why they know that getting Superman back is their real chance to be able to take down this invasion, because obviously, if the mother boxes are scared of Superman, Superman's gotta be pretty powerful because they were afraid of him to call out. So if they can get him back, that increases their chances of winning drastically. So it's a pretty cool moment, and Batman says, we're six, not five. There is no us without him. And technically, he's not wrong because Superman was the first superhero to expose himself to the rest of the world and show everybody that superheroes do exist, and everyone else kind of came out of the woodwork later. Although, technically, that does clash with Wonder Woman 84, but let's not really get into that. So then the final scene that we get to see is the Martha and Lois scene. Basically, Martha goes to Lois to try and get her because she stopped going to work after Superman died, and she's visiting Superman every single day. So Martha basically comes and sits down with her and says, listen, I'm the only person on the planet who feels the way you feel because I knew Clark and I knew Superman both equally, and I knew like my son, and I loved him deeper than just the symbol of Superman. And Lois agrees with her and says, if there's anything I can do to help you, like get through this. And she says, yeah, there's something you can do. You can come back to the land of the living. You need to go back to your life, move on. Superman's gone, but the world needs you. You kind of need to do your thing. And then after she steps out, Martha steps out, it's actually exposed that she is the Martian Manhunter, which was a really, really cool scene, but it does kind of bring up some questions. So yeah, Martian Manhunter came out, and that's Harry Lennix's character. Basically, that's Calvin Swanwick. He's the general that was in Man of Steel and Batman v Superman, working closely with Superman and working with Lois Lane. So Martian Manhunter is known this whole time, but that does bring up some questions. Where was Martian Manhunter during the events of Man of Steel? I mean, he was there. Why did he not interfere? Did he think Superman could handle it? Where was he during the events of Batman v Superman? He was there. Obviously, he was watching Doomsday and Superman fight. Why did he not try to assist Superman? And he obviously has the strength to be able to penetrate Doomsday's skin with kryptonite without kryptonite actually hurting him. So maybe he'd have a better chance in actually stabbing Doomsday with the spear. So why did he not act? Now, there are a couple of reasons for this that could be the case. I mean, he is obviously from Mars, but he could also think he doesn't owe Earth that. To kind of sacrifice his life basically to fight Zod, or sacrifice his life to fight Doomsday, because those two guys are Superman level or higher, and maybe even in Doomsday's case, but they are super powerful, so maybe he didn't want to sacrifice himself, but that does kind of make him look a little cowardly. Now the question comes up, does he trust humanity to accept him? To expose himself like that. Because obviously, Superman was under criticism from the moment that he exposed himself. The first thing they did, and that was always also Calvin Swanwick's character, was arrest Superman and actually bring him in for questioning and interrogation. So he knew that would happen to him. And then in Batman v Superman, Lex and Bruce were both trying to kill Superman. So obviously, if you're seeing all this kind of stuff, you don't really want to go out there and expose yourself to humanity that way. But then the question does come up, why did he not act in the Steppenwolf War? Why does he not come in and help them out at any point of this? Because he says humanity needs you, and he's bringing Lois Lane back because humanity needs her, but humanity also needs the Martian Manhunter. So it would have been cool if he kind of stepped in at some point and did something there. Anyways, guys, that is the part 4. It is really, really cool. It was an awesome part. Tell me what you think.
This is the Marvel Knight, and I need you to like, comment, and subscribe.